Here in Africa, Somalia's president, Mohamed Abdullahi Mohamed, says he has suspended Prime Minister Hussein Roble's powers, sparking accusations of an indirect coup amid a protracted feud that has seen both leaders trade allegations over the holding up of parliamentary elections. The move on Monday intensified a month-long constitutional crisis and raised fears of violence, prompting the United States to call for calm. It added that the Marine Forces commander was also under investigation for corruption and had been suspended. In response, Roble's office called the statement outrageous, saying on Twitter the attempt to militarily take over the office of the prime minister was in breach of the law. The U.S. Embassy in Somalia, in a Twitter post, said it strongly urged Somalia's leaders to take immediate steps to de-escalate tensions in Mogadishu, refrain from provocative actions, and avoid violence. Professor of International Relations and Strategic Studies, David Aworawo, joins me on the news from Lagos via Zoom to discuss this. Good to have you join us, Professor Aworawo.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So this is the latest in when you look at the power struggle between Prime Minister Mohamed, Prime Minister Roble and President Mohamed. But let's talk about stability in that country. There are now fears that this might take away from the election, which has deadline has already passed. And then we also see that the president's term in office had already expired in February. And yet, you know, he continues to stay in office. And people are scared of political stability in that country. What do you make of this?
Well, to talk of political stability in a situation like this is to just be wishing for what will never happen, is to be idealistic. It continues to baffle one why African leaders continue to do the same thing that plunges their countries into crisis. Elections, I mean, the tenure of the President Mohamed Abdullahi, expired since February. And through some machinations, through some, you know, clever antics, he managed to, you know, hang on to power. And new arrangements for elections to be held so that the political crisis can be resolved. As we just approached that point now, another crisis again has been created, I mean, ostensibly for the president to continue to hang on to power. And now the prime minister says he has not been, the president has no power to sack him. And so we have the president saying the prime minister has been sacked, and then the prime minister saying the president has no power to sack him. So the country, to talk of stability is to be in a state of illusion. It's unfortunate that these two leaders have taken actions that will further deepen the instability of Somalia.
And we also saw that action yesterday in that country, where forces in or men or agents in the security force who are loyal to the president tried to forcefully remove the prime minister from office, but that was repelled. Are you also worried in terms of security? Here is a country that is fighting insurgency, Islamic insurgency, and then having forces divided in terms of loyalty to the president and prime minister, that could have significant effect on security in Somalia.
Exactly. The country has been battling Al-Shabaab for a long time. The country has been a failed state since 1994, managed to establish some stability in 2012 when the current political arrangement was put in place. Less than 10 years after, the actions and inactions and selfishness of these leaders, you know, have brought this country to, you know, the edge once again at this point. The military will not have, of course, the military will not have factions that will be supporting either side of the divide. And the consequence of all of this will be insecurity for the entire country. And then the insurgents, Al-Shabaab and the rest of them, the terrorists, will not have space to be able to operate. Because when you have this kind of vacuum, when you have this kind of infighting, when you have this kind of conflict between different sides of the military, of course, this simply creates the space for the terrorists to be able to operate. So it's an unfortunate thing that has happened in Somalia, the infighting between these leaders who are not patriotic, who are not committed to the common good in their country.
And this is sort of similar to the events we saw in Sudan just before the coup, where both the military and civilians governments were not able to, coalition were not able to reach an agreement. And just shortly after, we saw that coup. But before we even talk about whether this is likely to result in that kind of situation, you mentioned earlier about Africa, just countries in Africa having leadership crisis. But let's also talk about countries where governments or long-term dictatorship have been toppled. It does seem that there is always a difficulty in terms of creating or forming a central government that is effective, whether you look at Sudan, the situation in Tunisia, and now Somalia.
Yes, it is basically the problem of the elites and the political actors. It's entirely what they do or fail to do. It has very little to do with the political structure itself. In the case of course, we see in Mali, we see in Guinea, we see, you know, coups are now coming, and they are now becoming the order of the day in Africa again. And a major, you know, factor responsible for this is the tendency for the leader to sit tight. When their tenures expire, they don't want to go. I won't continue to ask, what is wrong with African leaders? Mm-hmm. Who are they not committed to the development of their country? Because by the time you have, you know, political crisis such as we are now having in Somalia, development to, you know, will occupy the back stage. So whether in Sudan, whether in Mali, whether in Guinea, and in other places in Africa, where you have leaders who are not committed to the common good, who are not committed to their country's development, who are not, you know, selfless. These are the kind of things you see. And these are the kind of things that need to change for Africa to genuinely develop.
And we've seen this statement coming from the U.S. When it has to do with Somalia, as it has to do with Somalia, calling for calm. But it does also seem like the U.S. is siding with the prime minister. When you also look at a part of that statement, they did state that it said something about siding with the prime minister when it comes to the pact he's taking for elections. But what pact do you think can lead to the escalation of tension? People are looking forward to that election. The deadline has passed. They're looking forward to stability or when it comes to politics in Somalia. What can be done? Who can interfere? Who can wade into this crisis?
Well, I've read a couple of commentaries here and there, and people blaming the United States. I do not see how the U.S. can be blamed, you know, in this situation. The U.S. is calling for calm. The U.S. seems to be siding, yes, with the prime minister. Don't forget, the president's tenure has expired. The president is there illegally. He ought to have long gone since February. And is there hanging on to power. Anyway, moving forward, what needs to happen is to build consensus, to mount pressure on the president and to bring the prime minister to the table such that negotiations will take place and a firm agreement will be reached regarding when the elections will hold so that a new government can come and then stability can be established in Somalia. At this point, the president, of course, he has his support within the country. And so merely just condemning and taking side with the prime minister will not resolve the issue. What everybody wants is for stability to be established in Somalia. And for that to take place, yes, the president will need to be, you know, pressurized. And then the prime minister will need to be brought to the table. There will need to be negotiations and consensus building so that, you know, firm arrangements can be made for the elections to hold, a new government to be established, and for Somalia to move on with its life.
And we're watching developments in Somalia. We'll see how this plays out. Thank you so much for your time. As always, Professor of International Relations and Strategic Studies, David Awarawo. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you for having me.